Oh, I think paddling into line up with guys, I just get so intimidated.
It's also just like, dang it, I want one of my friends out here. I was very, very intimidated. Every time I'm surfing, I get hit on.
I mean, it's so normal that it's not even intimidating anymore.
You gotta use your girl advantage as much as you can because, like, boys are so much more scared of girls. So, like, if a girl's just, like, come up and be like, oh, hi, you know, they'll probably be like, why is she talking to me? Like, what am I doing?
It's really funny when guys are like, oh, like, yeah, like, it's cool that you're surfing and stuff. And I'm like, yeah. And then I'm like a better surfer than them.
Yeah. We kind of surf better than them.
And they're like, oh.
It is pretty hard to become a pro surfer, especially for us females.
If I see a woman sitting out at the peak, it's like, okay, well, you know, that's great confidence. Me, I'll be like, okay, well, maybe I can sit out there too.
I feel like women surfers have to deal with different things than men have to deal with.
On the championship tour, there is an unequal amount of spots.
I feel like a lot of girls won't get sponsored because they don't meet the company standards. Even though you surf really well, you're not pretty enough. The men, doesn't matter what they look like because they're just surfing.
If your surfing speaks enough, that you deserve to have a spot.
There's definitely a conscious effort to make the waves of that the women and the men surf different. The women surf more mellow waves like Honolulu, and the men usually surf a lot more dangerous waves like pipe.
So pipeline is a very critical wave. It is
probably the scariest wave in the world.
Basically, the best surfers in the world struggle with.
Just it's a scary wave. That lineup is intimidating, not only because of the wave, but on the normal day, it is packed with the best men.
There's normally just 100 men out there.
Moana is one of the few women that can paddle out to pipe and just charge.
I think she's definitely made almost like an opportunity for many more girls to surf pipe.
It feels really good knowing that, wow, I like did something that is pretty against the odds. There's no contest for the girls at pipe, really.
We haven't had a female presence on the North Shore of Oahu in over 10 years.
I think it's not fair that women don't have the same opportunities.
A lot of women would love to surf it, and it'd be a nice challenge to like train there if there was a contest for women.
So the first event for our 2020-2021 championship tour was, it started off on Maui, and then unfortunately, because of some circumstances, we ended up shifting and running the remainder of the heats at Pipeline.
There will be no competition today at Honolulu Bay for the Maui Pro presented by Roxy, following a shark incident this morning with a recreational surfer.
I felt for the women because, like, you know, just having something moved from Maui to Pipeline, two completely different waves, is really tricky.
For the first time ever in women's surfing history, the Maui Pro presented by Roxy moving to Pipeline, and a couple of world champs battling it out. Scores are in.
This moment here is going to have an impact on women's surfing around the world. And there's young little girls now looking at this going, Pipeline's on the agenda. That's what I'm going to do. And they're going to start dreaming of it.
I'm excited to see when the time is right to pass the baton on and see where the next generation is going to take it.
We actually have a lot to give, and we have pushed a lot, and so I think we just have to keep pushing.
Don't give up. Just keep trying until you accomplish what you want to accomplish.
Be yourself.
Never be scared to try anything new.
Kaikaina
It means little sister.
Having Kaikaina mean a sense of responsibility and kuleana, and make sure that you're always supporting each other.
I have my little sister, but I consider all the girls here my Hanai little sisters too. Can't wait to see what they're gonna do in the future.